Two of them just seem to be on the point of wobbly, being rather wobbly under the pressure. Hasn't stopped them a bit, though. They must be in great shape to take the pounding they're handing out to each other. Though it's been clean, it's been very rugged. Face off in the Montreal zone to the left with Henri Richard, Bonin, Moore, Johnson, and Talbot. Score is tied 1-1, 3 minutes and 30 seconds. Bond shot the puck to Olmstead, but he couldn't control it. Plot out of his net to Johnson, to Moore, who deflects it out to center ice. Stewart of the Leafs failed to trap it. Henri Richard goes to the corner at Leaf territory. He centered it right in front. Bonin tried to get his shot. It was a weak one, and Bauer covered up. Then Brewer takes Henri Richard over to the net, and Henri Richard didn't like that. Henri Richard has been playing a great game for Canadians. Was shoved around a bit there by Brewer, who seemed to push him over by the goalpost near Bauer. And that nearly started a mix-up. The referee just stands by there and takes a good look. Eddie Power's number 5. There'll be no penalty on the play, but a lot of talk went on just the same. They have 3 minutes and 13 seconds remaining in the second period.
Score is tied 1-1. And from the draw, the puck is against the boards. Olmstead and Henri Richard covered. Stewart comes out for the Leafs to center. Stopped by the defense. Pulford then comes over the line. A pass to Olmstead. Olmstead trying to get his backhand. Pulford missed it. As Blatt knocked the Leaf player down. Bond takes his shot. It goes to the opposite wing. Olmstead and driving. Score!
Canadian player just seemed to have the whammy with that shot. It was almost seemed to be in line with the goal, but it caught the corner past Plante. And that gives the Toronto Maple Leafs the lead for the second time in the game with less than 3 minutes remaining in the second period. And you hear the Maple Leaf fans cheering, "Go Maple Leafs, go!" You can hear it.
Behind the goal, comes out on the right wing. Bonin leading a dangerous push to Moore. Moore at center, over the blue line. A dump pass to Bonin into the corner. He's knocked off to the side. Moore trying to centering. He does. It goes off to the corner. The Canadians putting on the pressure as they trail 2-1. Montreal being watched. Horton of the Leafs is knocked down. Harris, a pass to Eamon on the right wing. Eamon going over the line, closing in with a shot. And he shot wide off the glove of Harvey. Back come the Canadians. Bonin with Henri Richard, who takes the pass. He tried to center it, and Stanley, a roll pass to Eamon. Turner stopped it. Stanley knocked the Montreal player down, and Horton clears the puck off the boards. It didn't go out as the Canadians keep putting on the pressure. Stanley, a pass to Mahavelich, to Eamon. Turner blocked that. Back come the Canadians again, over the line. Henri Richard, watched by Harris. Horton cleared it into the corner to Mahavelich. Mahavelich, a cleared pass to Harris, just failed to click. Turner rolls it back in, and Horton brings it up. Horton knocked down. There's going to be a penalty. That was a funny one. Moore went to check Horton, and his stick caught in Horton's skate. Have the odd man advantage. The Canadians are trailing 2-1. Pass over to Provo. He shoots the puck to Brewer of the Leafs. He gets it ahead to Regan. Regan clears the puck in. Harvey, man, the Leafs player. And again, Harvey, a penalty on with Brewer.
Here's some more penalties coming. Harvey and Brewer, possibly. Harvey grabbed at Brewer as he went by, swung him around, and Brewer back at them, and they're both going off. So Harvey in the box first, number two for Canadians. The Canadians will have two men short. The Leafs will have one as Brewer, 18, goes in the box. So after quite a lag in penalties, they're starting in again. So that's five in the second period. Each had minor penalties. So the face-off will be in the Montreal Canadian zone to the right. They have about 57 seconds left in the second period. 2-1 for the Leafs.
On the face-off, the puck is cleared down the ice. The Maple Leafs have to go back for it. There's 50 seconds remaining now in the second period. 2-1 for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Stanley, a pass to Eamon. Stop. Horton passes to Stanley. Back to Horton. Turner of Montreal comes up and gets the puck, cleared it back to Johnson. Johnson shoots the puck down the ice, and there's 30 seconds left in the second period. 2-1. As Stanley comes up with a pass to Mihailovic. Mihailovic at center, over the line, going into the corner, trying to pass it back. He does to Stanley. Stanley nearly lost it. Stanley gets it over to Horton. Horton pulls him with a shot. That's wide. Mihailovic cleared it right in front of the net, and Plott picked it up, and they go free.
The Leafs still have the advantage in manpower. Canadians have two men off. The Leafs one, and they have 6 seconds, as you see by the clock, remaining. The score 2-1 for the Leafs nearing the end of the second period. The reserves are coming over the boards now as the Leafs select to change their defense.
Ready for the faceoff. 6 seconds left in the second period. Mihailovic gets the puck in the corner, cleared it back, even missed it, and the puck goes out to center ice as the bell goes to end the second period.
And the Leafs have that one-goal lead, and the goal by Bert Olmsted from Pulford and Stewart late in the period at 17-11. They outshot Montreal in the second period 8-7.
Coming up next, the Hot Stove League by Satellite will connect the nation and talk about the 95 NHL season when we come back on Hockey Night Classics. In just a moment. I hope Bert Olmsted's watching this in Calgary tonight. One of the great men of hockey with the go-ahead goal. The Leafs leading the Habs 2-1 after two periods of play. We'll continue to relive 1959 as we move along, but for the moment, our focus shifts to 1995 in the new season. Dick Irvin's with me here at our Classics Control Room in Toronto. Four men you haven't heard from in a while are with us as well. In Vancouver's John Garrett, Jim Poplinski's in Calgary tonight. Harry Neal has joined us in Toronto, and in St. John's, Newfoundland, there's Bob Cole. And fellas, let's look ahead. First with you, John, the top team in Canada was the Vancouver Canucks. News is supposed to be all good, but it's bad there. Pavel Bure's not joined the Canucks. What's going on?
Pavel Bure's agent, Ron Salser, says they've had nothing but problems with the Canucks and Pavel's new contract. He said Pavel's signing bonus, $1 million signing bonus, was 3 months late. They had to beg for that. And now the Canucks are saying, because the 36 games weren't played, they do not owe Pavel the $1.5 million that he would have earned during that 36-game period. The Canucks, on the other hand, say that Pavel's contract was guaranteed for off-ice injuries and off-ice injuries only, and therefore they don't have to pay that $1.5 million.
We forget that last year Vancouver was just a point over 500 during the year. A lot of that was the Peter Nedved ordeal. How much of an impact will this have with Bure, and what's going to happen?
They'll be an ordinary team. He is their one superstar. He gets the fans out of the seats every time he touches the puck. But they still are a good, solid team. They'll be at least a 500 team, and it'll be Vancouver and Calgary in this division.
Okay, what about a 48-game year, John? What do you expect from it?
I really think that the coaches and the players alike will approach this as a stretch drive. There will be more fights in the first 2 weeks of this season than we saw in the first 2 months of last season. I'm really looking forward to it.
All right, Pep, I know you're anxious to get involved in this segment. What do you see from a 48-game season?
Well, I'll tell you what, Ron. At first, I thought the amount of time that players had spent together over the last 3 or 4 months, it would have meant that there were some friendships developed, and it would take a little bit of time to get rid of those friendships. And this morning, I was down at the rink, and I got chatting with Gary Roberts a little bit, and I mentioned that philosophy to him, and he said, I think you're right. He said, I think it'll take about 20 minutes before we get into it. Roberts has been skating with Dana Merzen as an example here in Calgary, so Gary is concurring with everything that John just said.
Harry, your former Marley, like Jim, your thoughts on 48 games?
Well, it puts a great deal of pressure on the coaches. You're going to have a lot of practices that are just after a game or just the day before a game, and that's a tough assignment to get to practice, so it's a good one for everyone. So the coaches are on the hot spot. We may see more than one goalie play every game for a team. Eddie Johnson was the last guy to do that. And I think, as all, the intensity in the games is going to be much higher on a normal night than it was in the 84-game schedule. And how about the older players? They're going to be fresh. You can win the Stanley Cup this year in 72 to 76 games.
Well, Harry, you talk about older players. I can't believe, Bob, you're not calling the game we're watching. But sorry. Where were you in 1959 when all this was going on?
I think I was doing senior hockey here in St. John's on radio.
Okay, and what was the mood of the Leafs and the Habs enormous in Newfoundland? It is to this day. Can you give me a sense of how people would gather to watch Hockey Night in Canada then?
Well, any hockey game on Hockey Night in Canada was great. We have great hockey fans down this way. But when Montreal played Toronto, it was huge.
What do you expect from a 48-game year?
Well, you know, playing within the conference and a 48-game schedule, it's going to be grueling no matter how you look at it. Nobody can afford any kind of prolonged slump. This is going to be quite a test. The East is not quite so bad. They're playing almost entirely in their own area, so to speak. This is to say travel is not so bad. The West, that's a different story. And really tough on Detroit and Toronto in particular. Of their 24 road games, they play in their own time zone, get this, only twice, and of course, that's when they play each other. I know it's a put-together, quick kind of schedule, but it's going to be one heck of a race for a playoff spot. Every game is a big one. It's not terrific, but it's better than the alternative.
Yeah, there's no question of that. A lot of talk about it in Toronto and Detroit having to travel a lot, but the fans in L.A. and Vancouver say, forget it. We've been doing it for, it seems like, a century. Dick, Pat Burns said that he just thinks the Leafs have got to make the playoffs. That's his assessment of 48 games and what he's going to do to get organized. What do you see happening?
Yeah, hurry-up offense for a lot of the coaches. You know, there's eight
coaches changes from the end of last season, including the Stanley Cup champions. And that doesn't happen very often, certainly. Oh, you mentioned Pat Burns, just to follow up what the fellows are saying. When they had the strike, Pat was coaching the Canadiens. And the first game after the strike, they played it in Buffalo. And it set a record in Montreal team history for the number of penalty minutes in one period. There were more fights. Denny Savard fought Dale Hawerchuk. I mean, I'm sitting here saying, what is going on here? Where's the solidarity from all the association or the union or whatever? But yeah, Harry referred to the coaches, and you know, the practice time is one thing. I think what they're going to have to do, I don't think the conditioning is going to be as big a factor as a lot of people think. These guys, the fellas we're watching play tonight in 1959, they never rode a bike, they never lifted a weight, so the fellas today are a little better that way. But I think, you know, there's some malcontents out there. There are some hardliners who have got to get their mind focused now on the right thing, and maybe that's one of the things the coaches are going to have to turn around within the ranks. And if the players think the coaches didn't have patience before, wait till they see them now when things don't go very well. It's no more wait for a couple of games. They'll make some quick changes.
And never mind coaches. What about the fans? I think they'll be eager to jump, too. An exciting aspect always at the start of the season is new faces in new places. There have been a lot of changes, some of which we probably don't even remember. Bob, what stands out in your mind as we look ahead to 95 in the season? Who do you see as maybe key people in new locations?
Well, you know, Ron, there have been a number of changes since June. Let me look at maybe two or three. Matt Sundin with Toronto. He'll be just 24 next month. 2 years ago, he scored 114 points with 47 goals. He had 85 points last year with Quebec, and he admits it was an off year for him. He's had four seasons in the National Hockey League, and he's averaged over 1 point per game. There's a question. The Leafs had to trade the popular captain Wendell Clark to get him. So there's a certain amount of pressure on him to produce. The Leafs think he can, and so do I. Rick Tocchet going to L.A. I talked to Rick during the Wayne Gretzky tour in Europe in December. He feels he has a new lease on his hockey life and a brand new challenge in Los Angeles. I remember Don Cherry exclaiming when Rick went to Pittsburgh, put him out there with Mario. Rick Tocchet was a big contributor to Pittsburgh's success. I hope for his sake he has a healthy season. I know he'll go to the wall for 99, and I'm sure he'll help Los Angeles make it back up. And Mike Vernon to Detroit. Now, Mike Vernon has been in a Stanley Cup final. Well, he's won a Stanley Cup. He's been more than a major part of helping Calgary be a contender year after year. I was talking to Scotty Bowman just a little while ago. He was saying it's not easy to acquire a number one goaltender. We believe we've done it. And if there's such a thing as a most important position, then it's goaltending. He'll be 32 next month, all the experience in the world. He is going to help Detroit.
And you're sitting at home thinking, Tocchet, well, that was for Luke Robitaille. He's in Pittsburgh. You're saying, Vernon, how did he get to Detroit? That Steve Chiasson to Calgary. Big changes in the blue line core for Dave King when you compare the start of this year to a year ago. And we'll get to Jim in a minute. Harry Neal, how about your refresher? What are you looking most forward to as we look ahead to the season?
Well, I think there are going to be some teams that get off to bad starts. Perhaps if you have a younger team, you'll feel better sooner. And if you have an older team, you'll feel better later. I think one of the favorite teams in the National League are the St. Louis Blues to win the Stanley Cup or at least get there. They've added Mike Keenan in three short stays in Philadelphia, Chicago, and New York. He made the finals four times. That's not a coincidence. They've added Guy Carbonneau and Esa Tiikkanen, two guys that will really help their penalty killing. They'll play a lot of shifts against the best lines on the other teams in the Western Conference, and their penalty killing will be enhanced completely. They'll have a tremendous power play with Al MacInnis coming over from Calgary and Steve Duchesne playing the whole season with Janny, Hull, and Shannon up front. Don't take any bad penalties against the Blues. Curtis Joseph is one of the best goalies in the league most nights and often is the best. And the main problem on the horizon for St. Louis may be the Hull-Keenan relationship. If Brett Hull, who has scored 50 goals or more in the last 5 years, no other NHLer's done that, can't buy into the Keenan program, St. Louis will have some trouble. But they are going to be much better than they were in the last 3 or 4 years and may well be the Western representative in the Stanley Cup Finals.
So you think Brett's sticking around, Harry?
I think Brett Hull has a chance to have the best year of his career. But he has to go along with Mike Keenan. He can't sing his own song out there. He's got to hum the St. Louis Blues song or he won't play much. Keenan makes no exception. If you don't buy the program, you'll watch the games.
Strange thing, Adam Oates was at center. He had 370 goal years. They go to a left-handed center in Janny, and you think that would make sense feeding a right winger, but it hasn't worked out quite that way. John, how about you? Transactions, what stands out as you look ahead?
I think the trade, the Mike Vernon trade, will really help Detroit, but I think Detroit's in trouble on defense. They had to trade. To get quality, you have to trade quality, and they traded Steve Chiasson, who last year was their best defensive defenseman and pretty good offensively. I think Detroit still has to make a deal to get a first-line blue liner.
Well, you talk about Chiasson. Toronto's also without Lefebvre and Rouse, and with all about Sundin and Clark, that'll be a big aspect again for the Maple Leafs. Dick, how about you?
Well, I like the Lefebvre thing. Everybody talked about Wendell, of course, and he's going to be the wake-up call that the Nordiques need, no question about it. But Lefebvre, I talked to Doug Gilmour in the offseason, and he thought that was going to be a pretty tough one for the Leafs to overcome, losing him. Of course, Garth Butcher's here. You know, you have to think of a couple of players who are going to be around who weren't. Cam Neely in Boston. And who's playing goal for the Boston Bruins? Don't ask me, folks, because I can't tell you the answer to that one. And Pat LaFontaine in Buffalo, who missed all of last season. And they're two fellows who are key to their teams, who we really forgot about it last year for the most part. They'll be back. Mind you, no Mario in Pittsburgh, I don't think.
No, he says he won't be back regardless. And Owen Nolan in Quebec's also back.
Right,
and Mark
exactly.
Crawford was his junior coach in Cornwall. So the Nordiques look to be great. In Philadelphia, everybody thinks Lindros will blossom this year. And Craig McTavish was just a brilliant get, albeit for 1.6 over 2 million. Love you, Craig, for that. Okay, we'll continue to look ahead to 1995, not 95-96. This thing will end sometime in July. More when we continue on Hockey Night Classics in a moment. If you're just joining us, Toronto 2, Montreal 1, April 14, 1959. It's Game 3 of the Stanley Cup Final with the Habs leading the series 2-0. We're continuing our look ahead to the 95 NHL season with a panel of Hockey Night in Canada experts coast to coast. And Jim Poplinski, I want to bring you in for off-season changes, people in new locations that might impress you.
Well, let me touch upon three teams that that no one has mentioned yet. Chicago in their brand new building, 205 super boxes. Phil Jackson of the Chicago Bulls has been quoted as saying that it's not near as intimate as the Chicago Stadium. I don't know how it could be, and at times it feels dead. So imagine the change that the Blackhawks will have getting used to that. Bernie Nichols, of course, is there. Chelios perhaps facing a suspension. He was injured playing over in the Swiss League as well. We'll see how that comes back. Steve Smith broke his leg last year. That will be a huge addition to get the Blackhawks back on track and contend with the comments Harry made with respect to St. Louis. The Edmonton Oilers have undergone a number of substantial changes as well. George Burnett, the youngest coach in the National Hockey League this year, 32 years old. Kent Nielsen is trying out with the Oilers as well. Peter Mihalovich is coaching Dick, of course, in Cape Breton and the Oilers farm team. Lots of youth in Edmonton and lots of enthusiasm up there. The building, of course, as well, has been completely redone. They've been working around the clock. track, and it's just magnificent, to say the least. So a lot of the problems that that the Oilers had with Northlands and all those issues that people got as tired of hearing about as we have over the last 4 months, hearing about the collective bargaining agreement, are behind us now, and that's a happy thing if you're in the West. The Calgary Flames have got a defense core that is going to be in front of the forwards lots of times, and I'm sure in a short season it'll take Dave King a little bit of therapy perhaps from Bearcat Murray to calm down when his defensemen are up the ice that much. Housley has been an unbelievable passer in his career. I was skating with the guys over the last few months a bit, and you really learn to appreciate a guy when you spend a little bit of time on the ice with him. James Patrick was not healthy last year, and he's in fine form and looking great. Zarly Zalapsky as well, I believe, is under contract now, and with the way he can jump up the ice, he's going to raise the hair on the back of some people's necks. So Calgary is going to be a different team than they were in the past, and with the lack of success they've had, it's going to be a very, very interesting season for the Calgary Flames.
Super, Pep. That was good of you to scan through the notes you'd made for October, November, December, and January. I'm looking forward. George Burnett did such a great job in the falls, and then, as you say, in Cape Breton, he's great. What about this rumor, Dick Irvin, that won't go away? And that's Montreal Canadiens and Detroit Red Wings, Steve Yzerman for Matthew Schneider, and maybe a few others thrown in.
Well, you know, there was a time when the Canadiens didn't trade to make the big blockbuster trade. You had Frank Mihaljevic in the 70 and 71, and that was about it. But then, a few years ago, here comes Kirk Muller, and then Brian Bellows and Vincent Domfus, and they don't win the Cup in 93 if they don't have those three. I don't know. The Canadians always seem to think, well, we don't want to upset our salary structure. It won't go away. That's about all I can say. It's still there one way or the other.
Then it must be true. Brian Bellows ends up in the Kordic for Kortnell trade. If you think about it, Kordic for Kortnell and then Kortnell for Bellows. So that one came back to help them twice in Montreal. Let's go to the West Coast. John Garrett and predictions maybe now. Any other things that you think stand out about this coming year?
I agree with Dick that the Yzerman thing, they need a defenseman in Detroit, and Yzerman either for Kevin Hatcher or for Matthew Schneider, something like that. And then Detroit all of a sudden is an instant contender, and I think they would be one of the teams that you'd have to look for. Coaches throughout the league, the new coaches, and in a 48-game season, sure, you've had training camp, but that was a long time ago, and it's hard to get your personality imprinted on a team in such a short time.
Pep, who takes the Stanley Cup this year?
Well, that's a tough one. I think that this is probably the toughest year to ever pick it. One team that that I would pick as somebody to watch out for, I can't say they'll win the Cup for sure, but I think they will be contenders, and that's Lee Nordique. I really think that Mark Crawford is going to get these guys going in the right direction. They had a very, very subpar season last year, and it wouldn't surprise me to see, with guys like Nolan back, to see this team really, really blossom. I think Quebec's somebody to keep your eye on.
Do you think they have the goaltending required?
Well, that's going to be a huge question, but you can raise that goaltending question with lots of teams, Calgary included. Is McLean, as an example, in Vancouver going to keep up the same standards that he brought to the playoffs last year and took Vancouver all the way to the finals? I think goaltending is a huge question right across the league, and for that reason, I'm still mentioning Quebec as an underdog favorite.
How about Jamie Storr in L.A.? Is he going to be the number one guy there?
Well, there's huge issues in goaltending. I mean, getting back to Calgary, similar to Storr, they make a commitment to moving Mike Vernon and putting Trevor Kidd in, and all of a sudden they've only got 48 games to tune things up. Not 48 games. They've probably got 10 games where they can make an error. LA is in a similar situation with Storr. Of course, they've got Rudy right there, but boy, goaltending is a huge issue this year.
Jimmy, in Calgary, when you were working out with the Flames, could you score on any of those three goalies? That would eliminate him immediately.
Unbelievable. It was amazing. I mean, it surprised me, actually, that I'm sitting here right now and not down at the Flames training camp.
Harry, who's going to win it?
Well, I think that St. Louis and Detroit, on paper anyway, have the best lineups in the Western Conference, although it's going to be very difficult for a Western Conference team to win the Stanley Cup with all the travel they're going to have to do during the season and during the playoffs. You have to think Jacques Lemaire's run last year was not a fluke. The Rangers just avoided the Devils. Coley Campbell in New York inherits the Stanley Cup champions. It's difficult to repeat. Not a lot of teams have over the years, and the New York Rangers have their work cut out for them. So I say it's the Devils and the Rangers in 8 games, counting the overtimes, to see who plays. The Red Wings or the Blues. Don't forget Toronto and Vancouver. They'll be heard from in the Western Conference as well.
Vegas has made Detroit and New Jersey, I think, 4-1 right now. So if that means anything, they like them in the Rangers. Who was their leading scorer last year? Anybody got it on the tip of their tongue?
Zuboff, the defenseman.
Rats. Harry, you spoiled the whole thing. Bob, how about you? Who's going to win the championship in 95?
I am not comfortable making predictions, Ron, but I have to, I suppose. Let's look at the West first. Many called Detroit to make it to the final last year. Well, Detroit is a very explosive team, we know that. They felt they needed a money goaltender. I think they have one now. So they have Scotty Bowman. He's been there before. They have Vernon as number one. He's been there before. And a bevy of goal scorers up front. I agree with John Garrett and Harry. They probably have to do something with defense. Toronto has some new faces. They'll be interesting. St. Louis has to be considered, of course. Vancouver, they've proved that they have it. And I'll tell you, the travel might get them all this season in the West. But if I have to pick one, Detroit. In the East, well, Ronnie, it was predicted by a fair number of fans that the Rangers would win the Stanley Cup last year, and they were right, of course. The Rangers have that great goaltending we talked about, leadership. There's none better than Mark Messier, a solid hockey team, I think, a taste of what it takes to win the Cup. That's important. A new coach, it's great to see Coley Campbell get a shot at being head coach in New York. He's got a wealth of experience. He's a solid individual, and the players love him. I'll go with the defending champs in the East.
And who wins the Cup, though?
He's from the Toe Blake School of Predictions. You know that.
Did I hear that, Coley? Did I hear an answer? Detroit
you
versus...
You got it.
Who wins it?
I wish I knew.
Oh, you're staying out of that. Good. All right. Play it safe. We'll leave that to Cherry and maybe to Dick Gervin. I haven't heard Buffalo, by the way.
Well, you know, that's exactly what I was going to say. I mean, if LaFontaine and McGillney are healthy, and they've got the Vezina Trophy-winning goaltender from last year, who's much richer now, whether that's going to affect his play or not, I don't know. The team called the Montreal Canadiens has a goaltender, but then they have to put the puck in the net at the other end. I have a feeling, I don't know, fellas, Harry, maybe you'll agree, this could be the year of the offense. This might be a year, the short season, when defensemen have a lot of trouble and the goaltenders have a lot of shots, and we might see a lot of high-scoring games and a lot of fun.
Well, the New York Rangers heard 54 years. Now it's the Wings who get that treatment this year, 40 years. So, by the way, Messier on Letterman last night said he'll sign Monday or Tuesday. So if you're wondering about that, I think Detroit, too. And that seems to be the consensus pick, if nothing else. Thank you all, fellas. Great to see you. Looking forward to next Friday and Saturday on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. We'll be back to Hockey Night Classics in a moment. Okay. We could have 22 minutes to just Wow. Hall of Fame members in tonight's game. Dick, this is your area of expertise because you run that thing, don't you?
Well, in the game itself that we're watching, there are 14 players, seven on each team, that are in action in this game who are now in the Hall of Fame. Add Tom Johnson to that list. Plus John Béliveau, who is not playing. You have the two coaches, Toe Blake, who's in as a player, and Punch Imlach in as a builder. Foster Hewitt is in the broadcasting section of the Hall as well as being a builder, and Wes McKnight, who's in as a broadcaster. So it is indeed a Hall of Fame show it was at that time.
Well, all kinds of individuals. And, you know, you mentioned Tom Johnson's not on the list there. There's one other omission, Dick Ervin Jr. I don't see there on that. And, of course, you're in the Hockey Hall of Fame, which is tremendous. It's not just about individual achievements, too, because these teams dominated the Stanley Cup year after year. Really, there were three teams that dominated the NHL in the original six, but it carried right from 56. Tom Johnson made the point. They should have won in 53, 54, and 5 and made it 8 straight. Anyway, go ahead.
They always said they were 2 or 3 goals away from 8 straight Stanley Cups.
Absolutely, because they lost in Game 7 in overtime, both 54 and 5. All right, we've pretty much got that covered. Let's go back to the third period now with Toronto leading 2-1. Once again, here's Foster and Bill Hewitt.
All set for the faceoff, and from the draw, Mihailovic gets it for the Maple Leafs. He turns around at center, a pass over to Eamon. Shot the puck into the corner. Plante comes out of the net. Johnson takes it. Johnson stopped by Eamon. Then Johnson of the Canadiens has it again. Mihailovic takes it away from him. Mihailovic coming out in front. Tried to get a shot. Ran into Johnson. Armstrong rolled it in front. Eamon goes to the corner. He skated off and Mihailovic has it. Mihailovic over to Armstrong. Armstrong's shot was knocked down. Armstrong tried to get it. And the puck goes back out to center ice. It's Mihailovic up over the Canadian line. A pass to Eamon. Back to Stanley. Stanley walks right in. Wait. Still has it. Passes to the corner to Eamon. Eamon shot it behind the net. Mihailovic goes after it. Mihailovic tried to center it out in front. Mihailovic and Johnson bump together. Puck goes back to Mihailovic. Grabs a hold of Marshall. Eamon gets it. Back to Horton. Horton slapped at it. Puck is taken by Harvey, and Harvey goes down the ice to center, up to the Maple Leaf line, a pass to Marshall. Marshall of the Canadiens going behind the net. Centered it in front, and it was knocked back. Stanley clears the puck, but not out. Turner is shot right in front. They score! Moore! Got the puck into the corner from Turner. Moore deflected that shot perfectly as Turner let it go from the Maple Leaf blue line. Moore was standing uncovered in front of the Maple Leaf net, and that's tied it all up again. So the Montreal Canadiens twice have come from behind to get the equalizer. And in the two previous games, they've showed the real power in the third period. We'll see what happens tonight. Now they're on even terms.
Puck is shot back into the Maple Leaf zone, and it's Brewer. Brewer tried to come out. He stopped by Bonin. Bonin centered it in front. It comes back to Turner. A shot. That was wide. And the puck goes to the blue line, but not out. Brewer ahead to Creighton, number 24. Relayed pass to Armstrong. Armstrong of the Leafs failed to go in. Henri Richard, a pass to Moore. Moore goes down, takes his shot. That ends up in the end blue.
That was Moore's fifth goal of the series. Olmstead was his third. Bonin, who has been the real trigger man, has had 9, and Harris has had 2.
On the faceoff, the puck is behind the Leafs goal with Bond coming out. Bond to Creighton. Creighton up the ice to center, over the line. Creighton trying to cut in, he does. Pass it right in front. And Duff gets the rebound, back to Bond. Bond's shot was wide. Backstrom from the other wing, knocked Brewer down. Back comes Jeffrey on a shot. Bauer made the save, hit right in front of the net, and Creighton has it. Creighton rolls the puck out, tried to get loose. Brewer up to center. Going over the Canadian line, takes his shot, and Plante covered that and holds onto it for a face-off at the side of the Montreal goal.
Canadians won the first one 5-3, second one 3-1, and they're tied now in the last period, first game on Toronto Way. And they face off. Regan, a pass to Armstrong, to Duff. The puck goes to the corner in the Montreal zone. Duff centered it right in front. It comes back to Stanley. A shot over to Horton. Horton's drive was deflected into the corner. It's left there. The Leafs try to center it. They do, back to Horton. Horton gets away from one check. Still has it. Trying to center it. Pass it back to Regan. Regan's shot was wide. Armstrong takes a drive that hits Talbot, then rolls it to Duff. Duff coming from behind the net, failed to scoop it. And Johnson of Montreal clears it to the other wing, and it was knocked by the Canadiens down the ice. And the Leafs with Regan, turning at his own blue line. At center ice, a pass to Duff. Over the line, a relay to Armstrong. He tried to center it in front. It's Armstrong getting it back to Horton. Horton shoots. Right off, and a great save by Flott, who got his skate in the way of that drive. Down comes Provo to center ice for Canadians. Over the Leaf line, chased into the corner, pass it right in front of the net, and Duff has it. Duff, up at center, skated off by Marshall. Hasn't handed back to him, and then lost it. Goyette leaves it for Marshall. Marshall takes a weak shot off a stick, and Armstrong of the Leafs starting to come out at center ice. Takes a shot right on that time, and Plant made a nice save by grabbing. Provo tries his luck again for the Canadiens, number 14. He's stopped by Stewart. Olmstead then traps the puck. Olmstead tried to get loose, and back comes Backstrom for the Canadiens. Stanley missed a piece of him, and Backstrom tried to center it in front, and Pulford has it. Pulford. A pass out to Stewart. Stewart back to Olmstead, and it was cleared by the Canadiens back to center. Stanley to Stewart. Over to Olmstead, and Jeffrion broke that up neatly. Back come the Canadiens, three of them up, over the line. Jeffrion shoots, right in front of McDonald, and Bauer made a sensational save. And Vaughn and Backstrom mix it up in front of the Maple Leaf goalkeeper. Score is tied 2-2. Wait 7 minutes and 35 seconds as Pulford failed to get out. Tries it again. Jeffrion stopped him. Jeffrion coming in front with a shot. That's wide. Pulford of the Leafs is being chased by McDonald. A cleared pass to Stewart. Back to Pulford. Up with Olmstead. Pulford comes up to the Montreal defense. Back to Olmstead. A shot. And it was stopped by Jeffrion. Jeffrion getting away from Olmstead. A pass to Backstrom. Up at center, up to the Leaf line. Chased off to the side by Brewer. Backstrom trying to center it in front. McDonald of the Canadiens rolls it in front. A shot by Jeffrion, and Bauer caught that one. And held on to it. The Montreal Canadiens are hurling everything at the Leafs, trying to crack them. And the Canadian team have had the edge in this last 8 minutes with occasional spurts by the Leafs, who have come close too. It's that kind of a game. It could go either way. It's a 2-2 tie, and they're just really ripping back and forth in terrific style.
Faceoff is in the Maple Leafs zone to the left. The Leafs in the dark uniforms, Canadians in the light. Here's a chance for Talbot, a shot, and it was stopped. Henri Richard passed it in front, another shot, that was wide. Moore is knocked into the boards, and back comes Eamon, up the center ice, up over the red line, to the blue line, and over, and he was stopped. Henri Richard gets away from Harris, a pass to Moore. Moore up to the Leaf line, over to Henri Richard, he's cutting in, he's chased off to the side. Harris of the Leafs to Eamon. Eamon, a long pass, and Mihaljevic was way back in his own territory. Johnson of the Canadians to Henri Richard. Henri Richard, a pass to Bonin, stopped by Stanley. Stanley ahead to Eamon. Eamon over the line, takes his shot, missed the rebound, and the Canadians have it. Back comes Henri Richard over the line. They're closing in with a pass to Moore, a pass right in front. Talbot just missed the rebound. It's cleared out and down the ice with a great score. Harris goes after it with Mihaljevic. Tried to pass it back, and Moore of the Canadians cleared it back down the ice. And Power lets it go by. Number 18 is Brewer. He touches it, and it's called for icing.
I'm going to mention Bob Turner. 2-2 in the third period. Jean Béliveau out with a fractured back. Doesn't play until the next year. Maurice is a groin pull, Richard, that is, so he's not playing. And now we've seen Junior Langlois, and that means Bob Turner's out. That name has a ring to it.
That's kind of a play on words here. I got to know Bob very well in Montreal. He's from Regina, and he was the best man when Dick married Wilma a few years after this. I'd like to mention the telecasting of this game. In this day and age, we have about 9 cameras on the game. Well, this night they had 4, and up in the booth there's only 1 microphone. So Bill would have it and pass to Foster and back and forth. Like that when I started with Danny, you know. And I want to let you in on something. They're considering that seriously for Coach's Corner this year. Only 1 microphone, and there's a big argument right now. Who gets it? Yeah. And we'll keep you posted, so stay tuned.
Guess who's considering the 1 microphone idea. All right, you can vote for next week on Hockey Night in Canada. We're back starting Friday. Just kidding, of course. Toronto at Los Angeles, Manitoba East, Dallas at Vancouver, Saskatchewan West. That's 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 PT. And then our doubleheader Saturday, a week tonight. It's the Rangers hosting Montreal, followed by either St. Louis, Vancouver, or Toronto at San Jose as we come back to Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
All set to go now. Here's Bill Hewitt.
Ready for the faceoff in the Montreal zone to the right. It's Goyette facing off against Armstrong. Armstrong failed to get it. Marshall lost his stick. Then Regan steals the puck, going in with Duff and Armstrong. Regan fakes a shot, passes it out in front. And the Canadians cleared it off. And down they come. Provo on the right side. Goyette at center takes the pass over the line. And he's skated off by Duff. And Goyette knocked the Leaf player into the boards. The puck goes to the far wing. Goyette rolling it back to the blue line. It goes to Brewer of the Leafs. And Brewer, a pass to Armstrong, to Regan. Regan with Duff, who takes the pass. Duff tried to go through the defense. Goyette clears the pass to Provo. Provo down the right wing over the Maple Leaf line. He's cutting in front, misses a check from Duff. Vaughn intercepts, and the Leaf player races to center, up to the Montreal line. Tried to go right through, and he was turned around by Harvey. Olmstead is on the ice. The puck goes out to center ice. Brewer waiting for his teammates to get onside. A pass to Stewart, and he failed to get into the right wing. Marshall to Goyette. Goyette up to the Leaf line. A pass to Marshall. He's taken out of the play by Pulford. Brewer, a pass to Stewart. Stewart, number 12 of the Leafs. Back to Olmstead. Too far for Pulford. Now it's Marshall of the Canadians, a long shot. Wide of the Maple Leaf goal, and Pulford's back for it. Pulford to Olmstead. Back to Pulford. Pulford up at center. Up over the Montreal line. A pass to Stewart. He's going right in with a shot. And a nice save by Plante, and the puck is behind the Montreal goal, and they hold it there. Harvey sitting beside Stewart.
Pulford set Stewart up there on that play as he cut in fast, and Stewart failed to beat Plante from close in on a rather awkward angle. The two-all tie. They've played 11 minutes and 6 seconds of the third period. Each team looking for that all-important break.
From the face-off, Stanley of the Leafs takes a long shot, just missed the linesman with the shot. And Talbot of the Canadians cleared a pass on the wing to McDonald, rolled out to center, and Horton goes back. Horton just lost it at the blue line. The Canadians come in, McDonald steering it into the corner, onto the opposite wing, and Stewart of the Leafs has it. Stewart trying to come out, overskated the puck, Jeffrey on getting set for a shot. And Horton of the Leafs goes to the other side. Horton now comes out with Pulford and Olmstead. They're over the line. Olmstead waits, takes his shot. Talbot knocked it down. Olmstead nearly rolled it in front. Backstrom being watched by Pulford, and top. Talbot comes out with a pass to McDonald. Up over the Leaf line, McDonald shoots. Bauer made a great save. And it's the Leafs with Olmstead failing to get it out. He did, and Jeffrion brought it back. And it was offside.
Watching that clock.
From the faceoff, Moore comes back for the Canadians over the line. Mihaljevic breaks it up. Mihaljevic straight down the ice over the line, and he just failed to get by Johnson. Canadians try it again. Mihaljevic breaks it up. Moore then takes it away from him. Moore of the Canadians, the pass to Henri Richard. Henri Richard takes his shot. That was wide. The Leafs try to get it out. Vaughn ran into Bone, and the Canadians, three of them all around the net. And Harris gets away on the left wing, stopped by Moore. floor of the Canadians. The pass in front goes to the opposite side. Vaughn of the Leafs rolls it out to center, and the Canadians go back for it. Johnson, number 10 of the Canadians, starting to come out. A pass to Henri Richard, up at center, up to the Leafs line, poked it over, and Eamon breaks it up. Eamon ahead to Harris. Harris over the Canadian line. A pass back to Eamon. He's getting set. He fell down. Brewer closes in with a shot. That's wide. Harris tried to cover his man. They bang it against the boards, and they hold it for a faceoff in the Montreal zone with Johnson, Moore, and Mihailovic all bumping together.
You couldn't get them much closer than that, but all of them can get in the screen. They're all jammed in there on the board back of the Montreal Canadian net. Nothing developed down the play. They have less than 7 minutes to go in regulation time. Each team striving for that all-important goal that'll break this deadlock. It was 1-1, end of the first, 2-1 for the Leafs, end of the second, and it's 2-2 now.
On the faceoff, Armstrong of the Leafs lost it. Harvey comes up for the Canadians. Up to center, a pass to Provo. He's breaking right in on goal. And the puck got away from him. Another shot was wide. The Canadians are all around the Leafs net. The puck went behind the goal to Horton. Horton of the Leafs coming out. A long pass to Armstrong. Out to Regan. Regan then turns around. Regan gaining speed. At center, over the line. Still has it with Duff, and they shot wide. Armstrong lost it. Gets it again for the Leafs. Back to Horton. Horton takes his shot. Off Marshall, behind the goal. It's cleared out on the right wing to Provo. Provo to Goyette, stopped by Horton at center. Horton leads the rush. Gets away from his check. Pokes the puck in behind the Canadian goal, and Goyette rolls it on the wing. Stanley stopped that. To Duff. Over to Regan. Regan took his shot, went to the opposite side. Duff has it. Duff was checked by Provo. Provo cleared it on the boards. Regan broke that up. Left it for Horton. Horton takes another shot. Oh, and a great save by Kwan. Armstrong of the Leafs from behind the net, trying to center it. Gets it back to Stanley. Stanley back to Armstrong. Back to Stanley. The Leafs player shot it, and it was stopped by Harvey, who shot it to the opposite side. Armstrong of the Leafs tried to roll it in front, and Goyette gets it back out to center. It's Stanley to Regan. Shot the puck into the Montreal zone, and Stewart, Olmstead, and Pulford, Vaughn, and Brewer come over the board. Canadians roll it out, and Pulford has it. Pulford with a pass to Olmstead. Olmstead stops, tried to hook it loose. Puck is knocked off the glass, out to center ice, and Brewer of the Leafs has it. The score is tied 2-2. A long bouncer, and Quant made the save, and Harvey popped in to the side of the net to cover up. Harvey of the Canadians, a pass off the boards to Provo. Provo is checked by Bond, and the Canadians are making a change now as the Leafs steal the puck. Bond to Olmstead. Olmstead shot, and Quant saved that one. It comes back to Stewart. He shot it around behind the net. Olmstead to Pulford, and he failed to get his drive. The puck is kept in. Olmstead trying to center it. Too well covered. Puck goes loose. Brewer takes a shot. That's wide. It's on the other wing. Bond clearing it into the corner. Olmstead takes Harvey against the board. The Canadians trying to get it out. Harvey is knocked down by Olmstead. Talbot then holds it against the boards, and there's a faceoff in the Montreal zone.
The Leafs are putting up a furious drive here at this stage of the game.
two all. All set for the face-off. The puck is dropped. Mihailovic missed it. And the Canadians come down. With Moore on the right wing. He's over the line. They're closing in. A pass right in front. And Bauer tipped it off to the side. The Leafs with Horton. Getting away from Bonin. A pass ahead to Harris. Harris up with Eamon. They're over the line. A pass back to Eamon. And he missed it. And Henri Richard comes back. Up at center. Up to the Maple Leaf line. Took a shot. Bauer juggled it. And Mihailovic has it. Mihailovic ran into the official. Still has it. A pass to Eamon. Eamon coming up for the pass to Harris. He failed to get away. Mihailovic lost it off his skate. Back come the Canadians. Henri Richard a drive. And Bauer stopped that and knocked it off to the side. But he held on to it long enough for a faceoff. Two minutes and 50 seconds remaining in regulation time. Score is tied, 2-2. All set for the faceoff in the Maple Leaf zone to the right. And for the Canadians, Goyette, Marshall, Provo, playing on the defense is Langlois and Harvey. Scuffle near the Maple Leaf goal causes another faceoff. Duff, Armstrong, Regan, Vaughn, and Brewer. From the faceoff, Langlois took a shot around behind the Leaf goal, and Brewer has it on the left wing. Brewer coming up the center, up to the Montreal line, ran into Harvey, then Duff of the Leafs. Gets over the line, closing in with a shot. And Vaughn made a great save. Armstrong a shot in front. Brewer goes after it. Cleared it to Duff. Duff back to Brewer. Brewer's shot to Regan. Regan behind the net. Still has it. Coming from the side. Took his shot. It hit the back of the net. Regan trying to get it loose. Kicks it to Brewer. Brewer's shot was wide. Regan to Armstrong. Armstrong of the Leafs back to Regan. And Regan lost it. And it's the Canadians coming up. Provo to Goyette, a shot into the corner. And Duff of the Leafs has it. Duff lost the puck. He then was bumped. And Duff of the Leafs gets it. Starting up to his own blue line to center with Pulford. They're over the line. Duff cutting into the corner. Trying to center it. He does. Right in front of the net to Stewart. His shot went over top of the net. Duff tried to get a shot. Another shot. Pulford is knocked down and the Canadians roll it into the corner. Montreal Canadiens trying to clear the puck out. And it's a chance for Marshall. Marshall takes a long shot and Bauer caught that. And Duff of the Maple Leafs has it. A minute and 12 seconds remaining in regulation time as he shoots the puck into the Canadian zone. And there was a man in position. Backstrom comes down for Montreal, trying to go through the defense. Stewart of the Leafs cleared it off to the side. The puck goes loose. The Canadians try to get a shot. Johnson shot it around behind the net. It goes to the opposite side, and Stanley has it. Stanley ahead to Pulford. Pulford up with Olmstead. They're over the Canadian line. Olmstead goes after the puck. It's stopped by Stewart. Stewart takes his shot. It's knocked down by the defense. Horton keeps it in. Still has it. Knocked it. McDonald clears it out. And Stanley waits for his teammates to get onside to Olmstead. Olmstead shot it wide. The puck goes to the corner. There's 17 seconds left. As Jeffrey on back to Talbot. Over the line. A clear cut breakaway for Backstrom. Off. From the draw, the Leafs with Stewart, back to Stanley. Stanley shot it off the boards. It came back at center. Olmstead missed it. Jeffrion has it over the line, and he went in, but the bell goes to end regulation time. And it ends in a 2-2 tie.
Then we're going right back to commercial, okay. And then, all right. It's April 14-59. The mighty Habs lead the series 2-0. The game is deadlocked. Leafs have got to have it. The big thing that's happening now at Maple Leaf Gardens is they're flooding the ice. How'd they do it in those days?
Very slowly, as you shall see. Not quite what we're accustomed to.
There's the two barrels. Ice Capades commissioned Frank Zamboni in California to come up with a better way, and he brought us the Zamboni about 2 years hence. Anyway, they'll get it done, and we'll have overtime for you when we come back to Hockey Night Classics.
Is the custom in overtime and sudden death overtime, the first goal wins the game. So no matter how you look at it, it's going to be 3-2 for either Montreal or the Toronto Maple Leafs. This is the third game of the Stanley Cup Finals and the first game of the series to go in overtime. The Leafs had two games in the semifinals against Boston in overtime and won them both. Puck is back in the Maple Leafs zone, cleared out. Backstrom flips it right back in. Jeffrion goes after it. Stanley to Stewart. Stewart failed to get out. The Leafs are crowded in their own end right off the bat. And Olmstead tried to kick it out. They hold the puck against the boards. It goes loose to Olmstead. Olmstead comes up to center ice. Takes a long shot. Plant stopped it. Steered it off to the side. It goes behind the net. Number 17 is Talbot. Olmstead stopped him. Canadians backed up in their own end. Now then, Johnson comes up to center ice for the Canadians. A long bouncing shot, and Bauer caught that and shot it off to the side. Horton failed to get out. McDonald tried to clear it, and it's Olmstead with Pulford. Stewart on his right. They're over the line. Olmstead shoots. A great save by Plant on Olmstead's shot, and the puck went over the board back of the Maple Leaf players' bench, and out come the reserves. And we have played 1 minute and 3 seconds of the overtime. First overtime session. Face-off is in the Montreal zone to the right. Duff, Armstrong, Regan, Brewer, and Bond facing Goyette with Provost on the right side, Marshall on the left. Puck is shot back into the Leafs zone. Bauer steered it off to the side. Bond failed to get out, finally knocked it out to center. Langlois covers up, clears the puck back into the Maple Leaf zone, and Duff is back for him. Duff, a cleared pass to Armstrong. Back to Duff, failed to work. Puck is still in the Leaf zone, and Bond has it. Bond trying to come out with a pass to Regan, intercepted. Now then, Brewer. Pass to Duff, back to Brewer. Brewer's check. Bond over to Regan. And Regan turns. The Leafs trying to get going. Regan to Bond. Back to Regan, and it gets by him back to the Montreal blue line where Harvey has it. Harvey's pass was stopped. Harvey tries it again. Harvey coming up for the Canadiens. Up to center, a pass goes deflecting into the Maple Leaf zone, and Armstrong of the Leafs has it. He just rolls it out to center ice, and the Canadiens bring it back. Marshall takes a long shot. Bauer lets it go behind the net, and Brewer of the Leafs has it. Brewer off the boards to Regan. Regan failed to get anywhere. Marshall hit the Canadian player with a shot. Goyette right on the ankle. And Duff of the Leafs starts out with Regan at center. They're over the line. Regan tried a pass in front. Regan still has it. Tried a shot. Block came out of his net. Regan trying to center it. Armstrong takes Marshall into the board. Harvey, at least Langlois, falls down on top of the puck. And they hold it for a faceoff. Harvey was just standing off to the side. So the faceoff is in the Montreal zone to the left, and we have played 2 minutes and 55 seconds of overtime, as you can see on the sports timer here at Maple Leaf Court. Faceoff is in the Montreal zone to the left of Plante, who is set from the faceoff. Canadiens roll the puck out. It's Henri Richard, Moore, and Bonin, Eamon, Harris, and Mahovlich. Pass to Harris. Failed to click. Eamon is bumped by Bonin. Bonin gets it to Moore. Moore with Henri Richard. They're over the line. A pass to Henri Richard right in front of Bonin. And Harris knocked it off to the side. Mahovlich is stopped by Moore. The puck rolls to the opposite side. The Canadians keeping the puck in the Leafs zone. It's rolled out to Mahovlich. Mahovlich turns around. Ahead to Eamon. Eamon off the board is intended for Mahovlich. Eamon is checked, and the Canadians get a break. Henri Richard with Bonin. He's over the line, takes his shot, and it goes high over the glass and just drops short of the end blues, dropping on the heads of the spectators. They played 3 minutes and 48 seconds of the first overtime period. Face-off will be at the rim of the circle. Maple Leaf territory. Score is tied 2-2. And it's Brewer behind the Maple Leaf goal. Still has it. Passes to Bond. Bond failed to come out, but he knocked the puck down the ice. It's going over the red line, and Talbot, number 17, will touch it. And linesman Bill Morrison raises his hand, indicating we have a icing. Face-off comes back. All set to go now for the face-off in the Maple Leaf zone to the right. Score is tied 2-0. We're in overtime. A shot right on. Bauer made the save. Brewer takes it behind the Maple Leaf goal. A pass to Stewart. Stewart to Pulford. Pulford is draped off the board. Stewart of the Leafs just failed to get to it. Puck is rolled out. Bond waiting for his teammates to get onside, and the Canadians take over number 10, Johnson. A pass over in the right wing to Jeffrion. Jeffrion comes up with a pass to Talbot. They're over the line, a pass to Jeffrion. He's chased off to the side, and Stewart of the Leafs has it. A pass to Pulford. Pulford rolled it out, but McDonald got back to take it away from him. Now then, McDonald takes his shot. Vaughn, stop that. Then Stewart to Olmstead. Back to Stewart with Pulford. They're going over the line. Ed Stewart, a shot, deflected off into the corner. Pulford back to Vaughn. Vaughn shot, that by Olmstead. He tried to center it, and the puck goes loose, and the Canadians clear it out at center ice. Jeffrion has a break, takes a long shot. Bauer caught that, and he juggled it, couldn't get rid of it, and finally did, holding it for a faceoff in the Maple Leaf zone. We played 5 minutes and 10 seconds of the sudden death overtime. All set for the faceoff. Puck is dropped. It goes loose to Regan. Regan to Duff. Duff out to Armstrong. Armstrong's over the line. Cuts into the corner for the lead. Shot it behind the net to Duff. Duff to Regan. He centered it out in front. There wasn't anybody there. And Langlois, Montreal to Marshall. At center ice. Up to the Leaf line. A pass to Goyette. Stopped by Stanley. Stanley rolled it out to center ice. The Canadians come back with a backhand that goes into the Maple Leaf zone, and Duff's back for it. Duff coming up to center ice for the Leafs. Up to the Canadian defense. Tried to go through. Marshall then missed a check. The puck is loose. It comes back to Stanley. Stanley takes his shot. Just deflected wide. And Quan covers up at the side of the net, and Stewart just deflected the puck wide of the right side of the net. But Quant was right there to cover up on the rebound off the board. We've reached the 6 minute mark of the first overtime session. The faceoff is in the Montreal zone to the right, with Harris, Mihailovic, Eamon facing Henri Richard, Moore, and Bonin. Talbot is playing on the defense with Johnson. Harris failed to get the draw, and Moore comes down the right wing with a pass to Henri Richard. They're up over the Leaf line to Bonin. Bonin failed to get his shot. He passed it in front. It's Henri Richard passing it back to Moore. There's the shot, and that was wide from point-blank range. Eamon covers his man. Bonin is stopped. Harris of the Leafs failed to get out. And Brewer, a pass to Harris, failed to get away. Now then, Mihailovic has it. Back to Brewer. Brewer up at center. Goes to the Montreal line. He breaks through. Goes after the puck, shot it into the corner. And Moore rolls it. Harris knocked it down. And it's called, as Mihailovic and Moore bump together. Henri Richard getting up slowly after running into Brewer. Both of them colliding, they didn't see each other. Now then, the Leafs are sending Horton and Stanley out on the defense. Harris, Eamon, and Mihailovic. Played 6 minutes and 42 seconds. Horton tipped the puck into the Canadian zone. Harris goes after it. Failed to check his man, and Johnson of the Canadians. Over to Moore. Moore at center. Rolled the puck into the Leaf zone. Bauer juggled it, steered it off to the side. It's cleared in front, and Eamon of the Leafs has it. Going up with Harris and Mihailovic. Harris missed the pass, but shot the puck over the line, and it's Talbot coming up with Moore. Moore's over the line for the Canadians. He's waiting. Still has it. Passed it to the other wing. Stanley took a swipe at it, and Harris has it. Harris to Eamon. Eamon going up at center to Harris. They're over the line. Harris tried to break through, and the Canadians break it up, and it's Henri Richard. A pass to Moore. Up to the Leafs defense. It's left for Bonin. Bonin takes his shot. That's wide. Moore tried to center it. Eamon gives it to Horton, and it's Horton coming up to center ice with Mihailovic on his left, a pass to Mihajlovic. He's going in, trying to get his drive. Henri Richard has knocked down Mihajlovic, has the puck going right in, and he just failed to get by Johnson. Puck goes out to center ice, Horton of the Leafs. A pass to Pulford. Pulford closing in with Olmstead. Pulford chased off to the side by Langlois. And they hold it for a face-off in the Montreal zone to the left. We've played 8 minutes, 14 seconds of the first overtime. Score is tied 2-0. Bauer is fixing his skate down at the north end of the left. And Bauer has to skate off. This game is coming to you direct from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. Ready for the face-off. Bauer picks up his stick. We're all set now. We're in overtime. Sudden death. First goal ends the game. Canadians in the white uniforms, the Maple Leafs in the dark. Face off in Montreal territory to the left of Plante, who has settled down now in the nets and all set to go. From the face off, the puck comes back to Bond. Bond shot it around behind the net. Plante comes out to cover up and holds it for a face off in the Montreal zone again. Score is tied 2-2. Ready for the face-off, the puck is dropped. Pulford of the Leafs to Olmstead. Back in front to Brewer, a shot deflected by Olmstead. Takes another shot right in front. Olmstead gets it back to Brewer. Brewer fanned on his shot and down comes back from the Canadians. And Stewart stopped that. Then Harvey of the Canadians tries his luck. Gets away from Pulford. Up to the Leaf line, going in alone. He takes the shot. Oh, and Bauer made a sensational save on the Montreal flare. Backstrom is checked, and Pulford comes back for the Leafs. Up to the Montreal line, closing in with a shot. Plante stopped that. It goes to the side. Backstrom cleared it around on the wing. Vaughn took his shot right on, and it was stopped. Vaughn gets another shot. This time it's behind the net, and Plante has it. It covers up. Plante came out to cover up neatly at the boards. Face off in the Montreal zone to the left. Score is tied 2-0. We're in overtime and we played 9 minutes and 15 seconds. On the face off, Canadians roll the puck out. Horton kicked it ahead. Provo gets a chance. And Stanley covered him. It's rolled in front and Regan has it. Regan of the Leafs has stopped. Then Stanley ran into the Montreal player. Regan trying to kick it out. He did to Dobbs. Johnson took a shot. That's wide. And Horton of the Leafs has it, number 7. A pass to Armstrong. Armstrong to Regan. To Horton. Horton of the Leafs is checked. The Canadians with Provo getting a break again for the Canadians. He's coming into the corner. He rolled it right in front of the net. And Duff rolled it to the blue line, but not out. The Canadians take a brace. Here's Provo's shot. And Duff broke that up to Armstrong. Armstrong off the boards to Duff. Duff straight up the ice. At center, up over the Montreal line. He shot. Score! Tried hard to get it, just missed it.
shot. That's it. Armstrong.
Time, 10:06 was the official time stop from Armstrong. In just a moment, we'll have the summary in the three-star selection, and once again, the final score is the Toronto Maple Leafs 3 and the Montreal Canadiens 2 in overtime.
What's the matter? Are we looking for...
Ladies and gentlemen, here are the three stars of tonight's game as chosen by Gordie Howe. The first star, Dick Duff, Toronto Maple Leafs. The second star, Henri Richard of the Montreal Canadiens. The third star, Bert Olmsted, Toronto Maple Leafs.